First of all, we will pick a standard solution of potassium permanganate. You may have any concentration, but not high concentration. You may take 100 ppm or 200 ppm. Then we will take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ml of this stock solution into 5 different test tubes so that we can get different concentrations of 5 different solutions of potassium permanganate. Then we will add water to all these test tubes, and you can see easily that 5 different test tubes have 5 different concentration of solution. Now this is our spectrophotometer, UV visible double beam spectrophotometer model number 2205. इसमें हम क्या देखते हैं कि यहाँ एक sample chamber है. हम इसी के बारे में आज डिस्कस करेंगे. इस सैंपल चैम्बर में आप आसानी से दो क्यूवेट एक साथ रख सकते हैं, एक रेफरेंस के लिए या ब्लैंक के लिए और दूसरा सॉल्यूशन के लिए. ये इसकी आप डिस्प्ले और कीबोर्ड देख सकते हैं जो कि इसी में इनबिल्ट होता है. देन वी विल टेक दिस chamber open. We will get it open. You can see that there are two stands for cuvettes, two different cuvettes. One is for reference, first one, and second one is for sample. You can see that two cuvettes can be placed easily because cuvettes are rectangular in the shape. That's why their holder place is also rectangular. So in first one, right side, you will put standard or blank, then left side you will put sample solution. Then from the back side of the spectrophotometer, you can see that this is the keyboard. It has F1, F2, F3, F4, F5. This is display and it is not showing anything right now. And from the back side of the spectrophotometer, there is one power plug, power button also. You have to put it on. As you switch on this power button, you will see display in the display board. First single wavelength, second multi wavelength, third spectrum scan, four time scan, five utilities, six calibration status, and seven online measurement. Then bottom of this display you can see five more display, visible on off means visible lamp, UV on off means UV lamp on off, UV visible, jab, date and time you can put. Right side of this also you can check the status, whether which one lamp is on and which one is not. According to these five bottom display, there are five keys. They are correspond to these things. First one correspond to F1, second UV on for F2 and UV visible for F3 and so on. These are numeric keys, and right side of this you can see right, left, top, down, and save, escape and enter keys. If you will press F1, then because it corresponds to visible lamp, so right side of this you can see visible lamp on. Status is showing visible lamp on. Visible lamp takes only half minute, and if you press F2, it takes time to get start. So UV on off, because F2 corresponds to UV on off. After pressing F2, it will take little time to get it started. Then you will see status that UV lamp is on. You can see UV lamp turning on. No, It is taking time. It takes 2 to 3 minutes to get it on. Still, there is UV off, and within a minute, it will be UV on. Means UV lamp will on. So, if your sample absorbs in the UV and visible both region, so you can perform practical in the same instrument. Now you can see UV on. It means both lamps are now on. First one is single wavelength. So you have to decide whether you want to perform experiment on single wavelength or multi wavelength or spectrum scan. In this lecture we will discuss only 3 system and we will see demo also. Single wavelength means you want to perform
सबसे पहले ये हमारा सैंपल होल्डर के लिए केस होता है. इस केस की लिड को हम ओपन करते हैं. यहाँ पे दो
सैंपल चैम्बर
अलग अलग क्यूबेट रखने के लिए स्पेस बना हुआ है, जिसमें यहाँ पे हम हमेशा रेफरेंस सॉल्यूशन रखते हैं, इधर हम अपना सैंपल सॉल्यूशन रखते हैं. तो ये देखिए, ये मैंने क्यूबेट लिया, क्यूबेट के अंदर मैंने प्योर डिस्टिल्ड वाटर लिया. इस क्यूबेट में आप
रेक्टेंगुलर
इस साइड देखेंगे, टर्बिड
ट्रांसल्यूसेंट एंड फ्रंट एंड बैक साइड,
और ये दोनों
ट्रांसपेरेंट. सो ऑलवेज ड्यूरिंग एक्सपेरिमेंट
इस तरीके से प्लेस करते हैं कि ट्रांसपेरेंट साइड है वो
In the way of the UV and visible rays.
So, similarly, मैंने आगे वाले इस
translucent side will be towards you like this.
And
transparent side
on the side of spectrophotometer. रखा है जो कि काफी light color का आप देख पा रहे हैं.
So you can see, I will put it in this way. I have taken first solution only, and this will do or examine both solutions simultaneously. And during experiment, we have to cover the sample chamber. So now, first number is single wavelength. It means I want to perform experiment on first. So I will press 1 because single wavelength corresponds to one number key. So as I will press 1, again it is showing second screen. Means you want to take absorbance of this solution or percentage transmission, or it is very dilute, you want to multiply it. Because I want to observe absorbance, again I will press 1 because absorbance is written on 1. Now it is asking on which wavelength you want to perform. So I will enter wavelength 360 because our potassium permanganate sample absorbs at 360 and 550. So I have taken only 1 and now I am pressing enter. So now it is adjusted for 360 wavelength, 360 nanometer wavelength. And you can see, you want at the bottom, first one is read. You want to read the readings or you want print out. So because I want to read, so I will press F1 because first display, bottom display corresponds to F1. So now I will press only F1 because I have to note down absorbance of the solution. So I will press F1 and now it will ask on which wavelength you want to work. You want to work on a single wavelength. So on which wavelength you want to work? So I will put 360 because potassium permanganate absorbs at 360. I have entered 360 by numeric key, then I will press enter. Now it is ready to absorb the to note the absorbance of solution at 360 nanometer. You can see that bottom first one is read and second one is print display, and I want to read only, so I will press F1. So if I want print out, then I will press F2. So now I am going to press F1. In case you want to change the wavelength, you have to go back. Then for go back, you have to press F5. So again, you will see previous display absorbance. So you want to note absorbance and absorbance 2.360, and by mistake if you press incorrect key, then you can clear it also. Then enter. So now this instrument is ready to note absorbance at 360 nanometer. Because I want to read only, and first display is for read, so I will press F1, and for print I will press F2. Likewise, each display corresponds to F1, F2, F3, F4, F5. Now it is asking number of readings, how many readings you want. I want 4, so I have pressed 4. Now it will take little time. You may get any number of readings between 1 and 15. So this one is first, second, third, fourth. Automatically it will subtract the readings of distilled water. Now for to go back F5. This time if you want to work not only on single wavelength, you want to work on multi wavelength, as your sample potassium permanganate can absorb at 2 wavelengths. So I have pressed 2. It means I want to work on 2 different wavelengths. And I want to note absorbance. So now I will press 1. Now first enter the number of wavelength 1. Means on which wavelength you want to work. First wavelength. So I want to work on 360. So I will enter 360. Then this one is wavelength 1. For first wavelength I will press 360 nanometer, and then I will press enter. So your first wavelength will be 360, and after entering it will ask on which second wavelength you want to work. Because I have selected 2, so I am going to press 560. I want to note at 360 and 560 absorbance of the potassium permanganate solution. Now this is enter. Now this is ready to note absorbance of sample on 2 different wavelengths. Again I want to read only, so I have pressed F1. Number of readings, how many readings you want. Suppose this time I want between 1 and 15, it is 8. Suppose I want 8 readings. So I have pressed 8, then enter. Now it will take little time to take 8 readings of the same sample. It will automatically subtract the readings of distilled water. So these are 5 readings. First one is at 360, second reading is at 560. So likewise, second, third reading, first and second. So you can see right side also, it is scanning your sample for every wavelength. You can see blink right side of the status, visible on, then UV on, then it is, its range is 1 nanometer, and wavelength is scanning every one wavelength it is measuring by the gap of 1 nanometer. Now you can see that 6th reading on the display, then 7th reading, and now 8th reading will be on the display. So very easily you may get n number of readings for any solutions. These are absorbance readings. It takes very little time to finish its job. Now 8th reading is also there on the display. फर्स्ट वन इज देयर, नाउ सेकेंड वन विल कम. यस इट इज सेकेंड ऑल्सो. फ्रॉम राइट साइड ऑफ डिस्प्ले यू कैन सी इजीली दैट इट इज स्कैनिंग योर सिस्टम 360 to 560, then again it will come back 560 to 360. It will scan for every wavelength by the gap of 1 nanometer. You could select 3 or 4 different wavelengths also. Now for the same sample, instead for single wavelength or multiple wavelength, I want to scan my system, my sample. So I will press 3 because for scanning it is 3. Now I want to note absorbance. So first it is asking scan wavelength. So scan wavelength means from which wavelength to which wavelength you want to scan, or you want to note absorbance or transmittance. And I have selected scan speed medium by pressing 5. You can see cursor against 5, scan speed medium, because medium speed is best, neither very low nor very high, so it scans properly. Then you can see first it is scanning the distilled water, that's why you are getting this type of line. And because actually I have not taken distilled water or conductivity water, I have taken tap water simply, so that's why this line is not a straight line and it has some impurities, so it is showing some absorbance and it will scan from 300 to 600. Now it will scan automatically sample also, and it will subtract the readings for distilled water. Very good graph. You can see absorbance at 360 and absorbance at 560 also. There are two peaks. For both peak absorbance is different, and it already has subtracted the readings for distilled water. And if I want print of this scan, I can take print of this scan also by joining simple printer to this instrument, and you can note it also. And if you want to take transmittance, so this is the curve for transmittance. This is the reverse curve. This time I have selected transmittance, and for transmittance I pressed 2 number key. So this is showing that how much light is transmitted from this sample solution of potassium permanganate. So this is a very very much reverse graph which I observed earlier. This is for transmittance. You can see previously it was for absorbance. It scanned the sample between 300 nanometer and 600 nanometer, and I can take print also. This is my second sample. As you know that I prepared 5 sample solutions, so this absorbance scan curve for second sample.
इसलिए मिल रही है क्योंकि हमने अभी
you can note down readings.
अगर आप distilled water या conductivity water लेंगे तो instead this type of line,
it absorbs you will get straight line
for distilled water.
This one is for distilled water. Now it will give for yes.
और ये आपके उसमें दे दी है
ग्राफ सैंपल चेंज फ्रॉम प्रीवियस वन
वाटर के कंपैरिजन में जो आपने सैंपल रखा था
sample.
उसके लिए आपको इस टाइप का ग्राफ मिला. इसमें आप 2 एब्जॉर्बेंस पीक देख सकते हैं.
सो इट इज वेरी इजी टू हैंडल एंड वेरी इजी टू ऑपरेट आल्सो. एब्जॉर्बेंस वैल्यू फॉर सेकेंड वेवलेंथ एंड फॉर फर्स्ट मैक्सिमा बोथ आर डिफरेंट. This one is for third sample. Again, you can note down absorbance and wavelength. So, likewise, this is transmittance curve. Definitely, it will be reverse in shape. As we operate our smartphones or mobile phones, it is just like that. For every function, there is a numeric key or function key. Just by operating one or two times, you can be a master of a spectrophotometer. You see how beautifully it gives. And automatically it subtracts the readings of distilled water. You need not to do any further calculation. At left side, this is percentage transmittance or concentration, and on x-axis there is wavelength. This is for my next sample, transmittance curve. I hope you all are enjoying this instrument. We can detect impurity also, we can have calibration curve also. You can use this UV for metal ion solution also. So on this instrument you can work with indicators or colorful dyes or with metal ion solutions or colorless solutions and colored solution, because it gives you a wide range of nanometer. I hope you all have enjoyed it. And for the sake of convenience, we have written all steps on this paper and pasted on the wall behind this spectrophotometer so that students can read it carefully, and it is helpful also. Thank you.